Earthquake early warning systems can give people crucial seconds to move to safety, but only if they get the message in time. Now scientists are shaking up what we know about such systems. New research suggests that giving people enough time to act before a sizable tremor may also mean sending out a few false alarms. All earthquakes start with P waves, which are fast-moving and cause little damage. S waves come next. They move more slowly but cause more destruction. Current early warning systems measure ground movement during the fast P waves to predict how much shaking the S waves will cause, and then send out an alert. P waves are fast, compressive waves that push and pull the ground in the same direction as the wave, causing little noticeable ground movement. S waves, while slower, move the ground up, down, and side to side, perpendicular to the direction of the wave, causing great amounts of damage. Warnings can be transmitted much faster than S waves move, giving people time to take action before the damaging waves hit. To find out how much warning time these alerts could give people, researchers imagined a system where people could set their own alerts, based not on the actual magnitude of the quake, but on how violent the tremors would be at their location, from barely noticeable to very strong. Scientists then calculated how big the earthquake would need to be to cause those levels of shaking at different distances. Someone 10 kilometers from the epicenter, for example, would experience much more severe shaking from a lower magnitude earthquake than a person 100 kilometers away. Finally, researchers estimated how long it would take to send out an alert. Because a more powerful earthquake takes a longer time to develop, alerts took longer to produce if they were triggered by larger magnitude shakes. In fact, people at most distances from the epicenter would receive no warning at all before a large S wave hit. But predictions for low-level shaking could be sent out quickly, giving people tens of seconds to act. The downside? Many users could see the alerts as false alarms if the quake never develops into a more powerful tremor. But if it does, it could save lives. Trains could slow down, and planes could delay takeoffs until the threat passes. That means that even alerts generated for small, insignificant quakes could be incorporated into earthquake preparedness training, so that people are ready when the big one really does hit.